We want to determine if f of x equals 4x and g of x equals x divided by 4 are inverses. Remember, inverse functions undo each other, so by first appearance, since this function multiplies the input by 4 and this function divides the input by 4, it would appear that these two functions would undo each other. But to show two functions are inverses, we have to show that f of g of x equals x and g of f of x also equals x. So we need to show both of these composite functions are equal to x. So let's go ahead and verify this. For f of g, we'll write f of g of x. Notice here the inner function is g of x, which is equal to x divided by 4. So this is equal to f of x divided by 4. So this will be the input into function f, where f is equal to 4 times x. So this will be equal to 4 times, instead of x, we'll have 4 times x divided by 4. Notice here these two 4s would simplify to 1, so this composite function is equal to x. So we've shown that f of g of x is equal to x, but this is not enough information to verify these two functions are inverses. We also need to show that g of f is also equal to x. So we'll write g of f as g of f of x. And now since the inner function is f of x, which is equal to 4x, we'll have g of 4x. And now the input into g will be 4x. And since g of x is equal to x divided by 4, this composite function will be 4x divided by 4, which again simplifies nicely to just x. So this is the required work that we have to show in order to determine if two functions are inverses of one another. So we can say since f of g of x equals g of f of x, both equal x, then f of x and g of x are inverse functions. So if either of these composite functions were not equal to x, that would be enough information to show that these two functions were not inverses. Let's take a look at a second example. We want to determine if f of x equals 2x plus 9 and g of x equals x divided by 2 minus 9 are inverses. Again, at first glance, since f multiplies the input by 2 and then adds 9, and g of x divides the input by 2 and subtracts 9, these two functions may appear to be inverses. But again, if we want to show that they are inverses, we have to verify that f of g of x equals x and g of f of x equals x. If either of these are not true, the two functions would not be inverses. So let's go ahead and write this as f of g of x. Since g of x is the inner function, this is equal to f of x divided by 2 minus 9. So all of this becomes the input into f. And since f of x is equal to 2x plus 9, we would have 2 times the quantity x divided by 2 minus 9 plus 9. Now let's go ahead and clear these parentheses and simplify. Well, 2 times x over 2 would just be x. And then we have 2 times negative 9, that's negative 18, or minus 18, plus 9. Notice here our composite function would be x minus 9, which is not equal to x. Therefore, these two functions are not inverses of one another. So even though this is enough information to verify these are not inverse functions, let's go ahead and determine g of f as well. This is equal to g of f of x. And now the inner function is f of x, which is equal to 2x plus 9. So we'd have g of the quantity 2x plus 9. So this becomes the input into g. And since g of x is equal to x divided by 2 minus 9, we'd have the quantity 2x plus 9 divided by 2 minus 9. And then to simplify this, we can write this as two fractions. We have 2x over 2 plus 9 over 2 minus 9. So this would be equal to x. This would be 9 halves minus 9 is equal to 18 halves, so we'd have minus 9 halves. So notice that g of f of x is also not equal to x. But again, in order to verify these are not inverse functions, we only have to show that one of these composite functions is not equal to x. So f of x and g of x are not inverses. We will take a look at two more examples in the next video.